I'm sure none of you with ears or eyes has not heard of the controversy surrounding Blizzard vis-a-vis China, vis-a-vis Hong Kong. Namely that a professional Hearthstone player by the name of Blitzchung offered his support for the ongoing protests in Hong Kong. And I wanted to take a different angle in talking about this, because I do think it is relevant. In the future, we're going to have more and more to do with China. Because I do think it's important to talk about that. China is huge. Companies are going to have more and more to do with China in the future. Individuals and groups are going to have more and more to do with China in the future. So even though this is a bit of gaming news, and it's mostly a gaming world that is offering commentary, criticism, support, etc., I think this is part of the bigger picture when it comes to China. So what happened was that the Chinese government expressed concern and disapproval for what had been said, and Blizzard consequently, initially at least, banned the player for about a year and also withheld prize money from him. When people complained a whole lot, the ban was reduced to, I believe, 6 months, and supposedly he should be getting his prize money again. But obviously, this has everything to do with China's influence, and specifically the massive, massive Chinese market. Not specifically for gaming, but for everything. Blizzard even went on record claiming it had nothing to do with relationships with China or the potential money that China might represent down the line or even currently. But here's the thing. All these protests ultimately amount to naught. The way U.S. companies operate, and specifically gaming companies, is purely based on profit. That's the way it's always been. And I'm convinced at this stage that most AAA developers or their publishers or whoever, Blizzard, Activision, could go on public record with a statement along these lines. We understand your concerns, but here at Blizzard, Activision, we are most interested in the fiduciary loyalty to our shareholders and improving profits for the sake of our shareholders. Any decision we make is only relevant inasmuch as we line our shareholders' pockets with ever greater cash flow. I think they could go on record and say something along those lines and be perfectly okay. Because this goes back to a point I made in an earlier video, a while back, about gamers as a constituency, gamers as a bunch of consumers. We, as in we who are gamers, are absolutely terrible. So these protests, sometimes accompanied by alternatives to playing Blizzard games such as Paladins instead of Overwatch or what have you, all it really is elaborate virtue signaling. Because the people who are actually going to participate in the protests and stop playing Blizzard games and no longer purchase Blizzard games in the future, they're a vanishingly small number of people. It's just not going to happen. And this is why I'm convinced that Blizzard or any AAA company could go out there and say, look, guys, we just want to line our pockets and increase shareholder profit. That's all we care about. If you have a problem with that, too bad. They could say that. If you have a problem with that, too bad, because you suckers are going to keep on buying our products regardless. They could even say that, and they still would. Does anyone here really think your average Joe is going to stop buying Call of Duty? Or your average Joe with an interest in football, or soccer as it's called in the U.S., is going to stop buying the 90,050.172 iteration of FIFA? No, they're not. They don't care about this stuff. They don't care about the politics. They don't care about whatever. So, yes, these guys can do whatever they want, and these protests are just empty virtue signaling. Yes, this guy had his suspension reduced to half a year, but he's still suspended. It's good enough to satisfy the so-called Chinese authorities, right? And on top of that, there's a huge measure of hypocrisy regarding the very people who claim that there's some political obligation or duty to protest this, and Blizzard is evil, and blah, 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 blah. Look, I don't love Blizzard. I don't really love any AAA company, not even CD Projekt Red. I think they're imperfect like anyone else. But effectively what we had here was a guy who voiced support for Hong Kong in opposition to the Chinese government Do you think these guys would be up in arm if somebody made a quote-unquote homophobic or misogynistic comment and then had his account suspended because he just wanted to express his views or make a joke? Of course they wouldn't. Of course they wouldn't. Never. Never in a thousand years. They would say, good riddance. This professional Hearthstone player, ooh, what he said is so homophobic. Ooh, what he said is racist. Ooh, what he said is misogynistic. Ooh, we need to get rid of him. Bad, bad, bad. So they're really selective about what they care about. They don't really care about what's going on in Hong Kong or the struggles the people in Hong Kong have and the conflict between Hong Kong and China. They probably don't even know the political details, but it's cool, and they like to virtue signal. And they would never back somebody up that they personally find to be anathema, such as someone who expresses views that they view as racist, misogynistic, homophobic, take your pick of whatever boo word they'd like to employ there. They simply wouldn't do it. And we're at the stage now with gaming broadly that these companies and the gaming world is so big, it doesn't matter if people protest. It doesn't matter if a couple of people, a couple thousand people even say, oh, I'm not going to buy your game. I'm going to play Paladins instead of Overwatch. I'm going to hit you where it hurts. Well, good luck with that. Because even if these virtue signalers were to hit Blizzard where it hurts, namely in the wallet, it wouldn't really amount to much. China is a potentially much bigger market than North America or the European Union. So Blizzard is playing it smart. They're maintaining this penalty because they do not want to sour relations with a potentially lucrative market now, but also in the future. People are up in arms about the Diablo mobile incident. I assure you that people in China were not up in arms. In fact, a lot of people probably bought that product. So maybe people in the US thought that was lame. People talked about it almost exclusively from an American perspective. We don't know what's going on in China. This is something we simply can't ignore. It's not just related to video games. But in the future, given the size and the virtual gravitational pull of the Chinese market, all sorts of companies are going to cut corners and make excuses for curtailing so-called free speech and curtailing this and that if the Chinese government doesn't approve. This is a lot of noise about nothing. I feel sorry for the Hearthstone player. Personally, I support Blitzchung and his ability to ply his trade and for his ability to say what he wants. But let's be honest, me expressing sympathy doesn't matter. And tens of thousands of people expressing sympathy does not matter. What matters is untold tens of billions of dollars that is as yet untapped, or at least partially untapped, that represents a pot of gold that we call China. And this is going to apply to all sorts of companies. It won't just be gaming. But again, gamers are the worst consumers in the world. We are. Complain about microtransactions and then spend hundreds of dollars on microtransactions. We complain about this and still buy the game. We're all guilty of it to varying degrees, some of us more than others. But it's a pointless exercise. This is another point. In recent years, there has been an insane increase in loot boxes. People want it to be legislated, okay? What do you expect these companies to do? They found a way of making lots and lots of money, of increasing shareholder profits, and then they get accused of greed. Why else do these companies exist? Yes, to make games. Yes, in earlier times, game development was more a passion project than anything else. All of the above is true, and yet they still exist to make money and to increase shareholder profits. So if they found a way to do it that is insanely effective, like with loot boxes, they're going to do that. I'm agnostic on whether or not Congress or some government should intervene and say no to loot boxes. It's not the same thing as alcohol. It's not a physical product. Pushing buttons is easy. It's easy to install a game, uninstall a game. It's easy to spend essentially virtual money and have it amount to a large sum of actual money, because all it requires is pushing a couple of buttons. How are you going to legislate that? I'm not really sure, unless you force the companies to not do this, and that's going to take a long time. And more recently, there was an NBA player that expressed his support for what's going on in Hong Kong, and China withdrew all sorts of financial arrangements due to that. So here's the difference in paradigm on a final note. You have essentially greed-based American corporatism, which doesn't really have a political flavor, although sometimes they pose as such or claim to have some political direction. They don't care, really. And you have China, which is all about ideological solidarity. So it doesn't matter for the sake of ideological solidarity that potentially billions of dollars will be lost in some basketball deal because the Chinese government didn't like that some NBA player said XYZ about them or supported Hong Kong, whatever. Very, very different ways of going about things. And my prediction is that long-term China will be more successful. I don't think freedom wins out. There's no cosmic formula called freedom that makes things magically work. China can pursue its path and the West its own, but we'll see in the end who wins out. But I'm sick and tired of this virtue signaling. All these companies are making more money than they ever have been. They just want to look cool, these protesters, these virtue signalers. And yeah, every major AAA gaming company, with a few exceptions, could probably just say, we don't care what you think or your opinions, just buy our games, and you'll buy them anyway, and get away with it. Anyway, I wanted to offer some commentary on this, because it's political, and at the same time, it's gaming-related, but it does actually portend a lot for the future regarding China, because China is going to become a much, much larger player as the Chinese market opens up, not just for games, but for everything conceivable. Until the next time, if I'm still alive, may the gods watch over you. Bye-bye. If you liked this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you enjoy my content, please consider making a donation or becoming a patron. Thanks for watching.